Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In this tutorial, I'll be taking us through the step-by-step procedure on how to make a girdle or cincture from start to finish. And please, if you're new on my channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button to get notified when a new video drops. Remember, subscribing is free. Stay tuned. So in this video, I'm going to teach us how to make a girdle or a cincture, which is one of the liturgical vestments used by priests in the Catholic Church. And for this project, I'll be making use of a nylon twine. And for this, I'll be using the size 9 for this project, and a crochet. For this, I prefer to make use of size 6 and 5, but for this project, I'll be making use of size 6. And finally, we are going to make use of the scissors. So, in order to start, I'm going to use 2 nylon twine at once. I'll first of all put the nylon twine together, put it together this way, and take it round your finger like an X shape. This way, take it round like an X shape, and take the twine, put it through and use your crochet to drag it out. Let's try it again. Take it like an X shape. Use your twine and drag it out. So now that I've dragged it out, I'm going to hold it, use this end, and tighten the work, tighten it firm. So I'm going to proceed and make a chain out of this, and in doing so, I'm going to use this loop, take my crochet, hold it, drag it out, and here I'm going to repeat the process again. Hold it, use my crochet, drag it out, and out. So I'm going to repeat it. I'm going to make 12 of this chain. Take your loop, use your crochet, put it in the loop, drag it out. So this is 3. I'm going to make 9 more. This is 1, this is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So I've finally succeeded in making the chain, and the next stage is I'm going to connect this chain to this other end. I'm going to connect it, so I'll make the beginning of this. So I'm going to use this, put it through the loop, this one, put it through this loop, pass it through. and use your crochet, drag it in and out. Now I've succeeded in doing this, and I'm going to use the crochet again, drag the rope, pull it out, and here I have my rope. So I've finally been able to connect this chain. So I'm going to proceed and continue the process, and I'll get to a desired length just like this one. So I'm going to continue the process. I'll put it through this first loop, pass it through, take it out, up, and here go, pass it through again, up, out, and here we go. I'm going to connect it once more through this loop, in and out, then bring it, use this once again. So I'm going to continue the process. So now we have our first row. I'm going to continue the process until I get to a desired length, desired size, then I can take another form. So I'm going to do this process again over and over till I get to my desired length. So to turn it and continue.
Don't forget, you're going to be taking only the other one side of the loop. You're not going to take the two sides, just this side, this end. Take it this way, in and out. Again, in and out. So, this is what we're having. Let's continue and do this. And now I've gotten my desired length for this work, so I'll move on to the next stage, which is connecting this part, which is the first part, to this next one, and then forming this particular part. So now I'm going to continue the chain. However, I will leave one of this loop and take this next one. I'll skip a loop. I'll skip this one, take this, skip this one, take this. And in doing this, I'm not going to do it the way I did it the first time. I'm going to do it once this time around. So I'll skip this, take this one, take it in, out. This time, I'm not going to do it this way again. I'll just take it like this and pass it through once. So I'll skip this one again, pick the next one, pass it through, out and in. Skip the next one, take this, pass it through and in. Keep the next one, take out and in, just like that. Then now you see I'm going to be passing it now. I'm not going to pass it through this place anymore. I'm going to pass it through this tiny little hole that is here. This tiny little hole, I'm going to pass it through. And then this one again. Pass it through this one. And on and on and on. This, you see. Pass it through this tiny loop which is behind here. I'll take this strand, pass it through, out. And this time I'm no longer going to do it one time like I've done for the first round. I'll continue just the way I did from the beginning. So I'm going to pass it through, then take the twine again and pass it through. So I look for the next hole which is here, next loop which is here. Pass it through, take it in, out, and then here, pass it through again, in, out. Through this same hole again, in here, and out. So So I'm going to continue the process. Continue in through this hole, pass it through, in and out, pass it once more, in and out, pass it through again. So you can see that it's beginning to form just like this one. It's beginning to take formation. So continue the process. Continue this process on and on and on. So you can see that it's finally taking form. So I'm going to go on and on and on and on again. So I'll take this off camera, make it a little longer, and I'll be right back. So I'm right back. I've made the twine to a certain extent. So we're going to continue the process on and on and on again. And then something I would like to point out is this. If you take a look at these loops, you discover that there are 5 in number. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And I prefer to make mine 5. And I usually make use of this particular measurement because most of my clients prefer it, because whenever I make this, they tell me that they love it and it's neither big nor small, so it's the best size. And I'm going to continue, but there's another thing I would like to point out is, in order to know that my work is ready, like I've gotten to a certain extent, to know the measurement of my work, I like to knot it, and I knot it this way, take it and knot it this way. This is 1 and this is 2. So I do this 24 or sometimes 25 times. Most often I use 25 knots. So when I have this knot up to 25, I know that my cincture is ready, like I have the desire, I know that I have the desired length, which is here. I can continue with the other part of it. So I'm going to continue this process till I have 25 knots or 24 knots. So when I do this, our work will be ready. So I'm going to continue it. Like I said, put it through the loop, take it out, put it through, out, and in, out, take it through, and in, out, through, and sorry about that, out, through, and in, down, out, in. Here I have a mark. So I'm going to continue this process on and on. Stitch. Please stay tuned. So I'm back and we've come to the end of this particular part, and I reached my desired length. So like I said earlier, I use this to take measurement of my work, and I always make 25 knots. So but for the sake of this video, I made 24 knots. So let's count together. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. So it's actually 25 knots. So I'm going to move on to the next step, which is making the end part of the cincture. So this time I will I'm going to make knit twice in each loop. So I'll make it this way. This is one, this is one. Then I'll move on to the next loop. I'll make one, and then on in the same loop I'll make another one. This is two. Then I'll move on to the next one. I'll make it one. This time I'm going to make three because I want to get two and three. One and two. Then move on to the next one. One. Then I take the last one, which is this one. So I'm going to put it in this loop. Sorry about that. I want to put this in this loop. Now I'm going to do on each strand. I'm going to knit once, no longer twice. I'm going to be knitting once in each loop. Move on to the next one, put it in, out, and in, out, and in. In, out, in. Out and in again. take it again, in, out, and in. So I'm going to continue the process this way until I get to my desired length, and then we'll move on to the final stage of the cincture. Put it in, out, in again. So I'm going to put it in, out, in, take it in, out, and in again. So I'm going to continue the process. So I'm going to go on with the process, on and on, until I get my desired, get my desired length.
I've got the desired length for my work. I'm going to move on and end this project. So I'll put it in the loop on both sides. This side, I'm going to do it on both sides. Put it this way. Bring it out. And here we go. And here we have. I'm going to cut this out. And yeah, I'm done for this. In order to make it tighter, I'm going to wrap it a second time and bring it out, and here work is complete. We now have part of the job is done, so I'll move on to the next stage, which is the final stage of the cincture. I'm going to make this. So what I do is I take this twine, take it on both sides, then I'm going to measure it, and usually I make use of my hand, my leg. I do it using my leg, and when there's someone around, I'll ask them to help me hold it. So I'm going to roll this thread several times. I'm going to roll it severally so that I can get it done. So I'm going to go off camera and I'll be back shortly to show you the work. So I've been able to roll this round. And now I'm going to cut it. So I just cut it out, and then I'm going to cut it the second time again. Cut it out again. So I'm going to take this, oh, put this down. I'm going to take this, place it on this list. I like to do mine this way because when you do it, it helps to hold the thread and stops it from pulling out easily. So I'm going to move on and start. Pull it out, and then I'm going to move on to the next side, but this time I'll make a chain of and I'm going to use it. This way. Drag it down. This is something I just came up with. So that my work can be firm and strong. So this is how I make my own cinches. I do it and it helps my work to be very firm. It doesn't pull out. Now I'm going to pull it down, take it down, bring down the So I'm going to do the same thing on the second part. So I'm going to move this upward. I'm going to take the next one, put it and do the same thing like the first one. Please place it here, put it through. So now we have a final done, and well, this is not compulsory, but I like to make my cincture this way. When I'm done making my cincture the way it is, you see that it is not firm and this strand can easily pull out. So I like to make mine very tight at the edge so that no matter how hard you try to pull it out, to be seam very firm and stiff, it doesn't pull out. So I'm going to do the final work on this cincture. So I'm going to look for one of the, take the longest thread from my work from earlier. Take it. at it here. Look for edges. Let's keep one, take the next one.
Yeah, and this is our final work. Finally come to the end of today's tutorial, and please don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel, and stay, click the notification button so that you can get notified when next we drop our content. Thank you.